Hello, welcome back. In the last video, I showed you how you make changes to your Medusa on Railway project and deploy it, or for that matter, any other Railway project. But it turned out this didn't exactly work for all of you. Little did I know, but by the time I made the video, I was using the template I deployed about 3 weeks ago. And just 1 week later, Railway had changed the system behind deploying a template. So it no longer cloned the upstream repo into your own GitHub repository. So by the time I made the video, I showed you that the source repo would point to a repository of your own and the upstream repo would be down here. And that's no longer the case. So instead, what you'll see now is that this is a template I just deployed a minute ago. And you will see that the source repo points directly to the upstream repo. So if you were to clone this one to your local machine, you cannot push changes to it because this is a repository I maintain. And what we need to do is to get a clone, a custom clone for yourself here. And so I was made aware about this issue over here by, if you find the template page, you see there's this little discuss this template. This is, by the way, a great place to ask for help if you encounter any problems. I frequently monitor this page, and there was a guy here, Stefan, he didn't have it working, and I talked a little bit back and forth with him, and we found out that the template system had been changed. I reached out to Railway on Discord, and this is a good opportunity to give them a little shout out. Every time I have a problem, I ask in the help section, and literally within 24 hours, this guy, Brody, he helps. It's unbelievable. This is so crazy. So good support. Anyway, let's see what it takes now to make a change to your project and deploy it with the new system. So right now, I think this feature is somewhat in beta, and that's why you need to toggle on a feature flag. So if you go to your account and account settings, so this is outside of the scope of your project. This is for your account, so for all of your project. There is this feature flag over here. And what you wanna do is toggle on the service eject. That's a new feature, I believe. And now we can go back to your project. I got dirty shade this time. So if I head back to the front end, go to settings, you'll see now there is an eject option down here. And we'll click that, and you have to choose your GitHub user. And now it will basically do what it used to do when you deployed the template. So it creates a clone of the upstream repo and put it in your GitHub. Let's give it a few seconds. Yeah, so I got a message, service ejected. And you'll see this is now not the same as the upstream repo. In fact, I don't have the upstream repo anymore. This is, we can click it and see that it's in fact in my GitHub and it's a custom repository. So this one we can clone just like I showed in the previous video. So I'm not gonna go over that again, but let's do one more thing. So right now you see it's building, but the backend is not building. And before we had automatic setup of monorepository, and that is no longer the case. So if I go back to the backend, you'll see that this also points to the boilerplate, which is the upstream repo. So instead of ejecting it, we want to disconnect it. And I believe you need to deploy the disconnect before you connect it. I tried to disconnect and connect it to a repository and it didn't connect the build pipeline correctly. So I think what I want to do is click deploy and wait for the changes. And this should be rather quick here. Yeah, so it's done and I'm gonna click connect repository and I'll see the one that was just created. And we're going to choose that. And you see that the root directory is pointing to the backend part of that repository. So it should be all good. I'm gonna click deploy. And it says building. I'm going to pause the video and come back when this is done. Okay, so both the front end and the back end are finished with deploying and building. Let's just check in here what it says. Yeah, so the first one is now removed, and this is the commit message from the upstream boilerplate repo. And then there is an initial commit, which was the clone, and that should also be here. Yeah. Okay, so let's just, for the sake of it, verify that we can actually make a change that will start the build pipeline in both the containers. Go to the GitHub, copy the URL, open a terminal, change directory to documents, git clone, paste in and give it a folder name, Medusa deploy test, and it's cloning, change directory, do the deploy test, code dot to open VS Code. Okay, I'm just going to put a comment in the bottom of the README to have a change here. Save it. Git status, yeah. Git add everything. Trigger build test. Call it whatever you want. And git push. Rightio, let's go back to Railway. Beautiful, yeah. So both the front end and the back end picked up the change and started building. So we now again have the same setup as in the previous video, where we have a monorepository. Just one Git repository that you can push changes to, either if it's the backend or the frontend, and they will both start building. This is such an easy way to maintain a project. You see that it gets this name. It's a copy of the name of the boilerplate, and then some random letters and numbers, and it's a little bit annoying. So you don't get to choose your name when you eject, but I wrote some feedback over in the Railway Discord, and this was on a Saturday, and literally some guy, he picked up the feedback, and they created two issues on it. Both the thing about monorepositories not being automatically created, and also that the name is weird, so I have no idea if they're going to do any changes about this, but I think this just shows how great Railway is as a company, that they listen to the users on a Saturday. That's pretty remarkable in my opinion. Let's see. Okay, so this is all for this update to the last video. I hope you'll now be able to deploy your changes. I learned that stuff changes. So I'm going to be maintaining this blog post here. I already put updated steps in how to deploy changes since the change with the Railway template system. And if you see anything that looks different while doing your changes process, then try to head back to this blog post. I'll have a link to it in the video description. Because chances are that I will have created some updated steps for you to follow. Okay, that's all for now. I wish you a wonderful day. Bye.